Inside the Paddock, live from Motorland Aragon. It's been a brilliant start here in terms of building up the title hunt that's going to be playing out over the next six races. Aleix Espargaró, despite a bit of a troubled session, topped the timing sheets in FP1, closely followed by Pecco Bagnaia. And then we saw Alex Rins, who's obviously here enjoying a more home race than usual at our Spanish races, inside the top three. It was also a really good session for Takaaki Nakagami, obviously very renewed by that contract extension with LCR Honda. He was up inside the top four. And then obviously the big news here this weekend is the return of Marc Márquez, and he'd finished just outside of the top 10. Perhaps one of the things we heard a lot from a couple of the riders after that session is that conditions not quite ideal, grip a little bit low at the moment. We expect that to improve in this afternoon's session as we get a bit more rubber laid down. But anyway, I'm actually off to take you to a part of the paddock we've perhaps not been to or visited so far this season. This is where the riders have their motorhomes, and Maverick Viñales has kindly agreed to catch up with us and have a bit of a chat and welcome us inside. So let's just go now and find out whether he, oh, the door shut. Where's the, should I knock? So this is quite cool because we don't really often come inside motorhomes because, hello, how are you? Shall I give you a mic? Am I all right to come inside?
Yes, of course.
Are you sure? Yes. Thank you so much for inviting us in. I'll just hold the door open. Maverick, will this door swing back?
No. So we pull if you want, or it, yeah, for the sound, maybe it's better.
Okay, we'll come inside here.
The Red Bull
Well, thank you so much for having us over. Beautiful, beautiful motorhome.
Well, you can see this is the where I live in in the MotoGP days. And, well, the motorhome basically is only for me.
Yep.
So, and for my family when we come.
I was going to say, I guess for you guys now, it's so important to have your own space, more so than ever before, because Nina and Raquel come to a lot of the races.
Yes, we need to modify a little bit the motorhome because there is not much space. There is stairs.
So. Oh, yeah, true. We know all about stairs with young babies.
I need to modify a little bit, but it's fine. I mean, when I'm here alone, it's enough for sure. It's really good. But when I come with Raquel and Nina, we need to modify a little bit, but it's fantastic. You know, I enjoy. We cook also.
Yeah.
So I try to cook.
Do you?
The food. Yes, a little bit.
Do you
bit.
Have I a speciality?
Like. Yeah. Omelette.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Yes. Keep I do good
simple.
Omelettes.
Perfect.
And then normally I eat here, normally. And I try to cook also as well, you know, because I'm a little bit maniatic. I don't want they put butter or something.
So oh, right.
I do myself.
Important for the diet.
Yes, yes, I follow very strict.
Maverick, in terms of...
I do mean, you like, want to sit?
Yeah, let's do it. Should we set you here?
Later, if you want, I show you the bedroom.
Oh, yeah, let's do that.
Okay.
Because I was just saying to everybody, we don't really often these days come and bother you guys in the motorhomes because of things like privacy and stuff like that. But it is actually really nice to have a glimpse at where you guys hang out. Obviously, this is the last time for what, the next 6 weeks, you will have this kind of... privacy, space to relax. Just for everyone back home, explain how different it is for you guys in between the sessions when we go to those flyaway races. Like, where do you spend that time?
Well, actually, I will explain where I normally where I stay. We have like a big like a box.
Yeah.
You know, like that. I don't know what to say in English.
It's like a container, really.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's a container where we have. Like we have a little sofa, we have some chairs, and also we have the TV, and it's the place we change, we get ready. So there we can relax a little bit. But of course, it's not the same than to be in the motorhome or to have the facilities of the hospitality. And yeah, it's a little bit more complicated, but in the same way, I like a lot.
Do you?
Yes, I like a lot to go on the overseas because, you know, I don't stay all day in the paddock. I can go to the hotel, I do different stuff. And somehow you relax a little bit, and that's fantastic. And also, what we usually do with Aprilia is we go all together.
Oh, okay,
so we spend a lot of time also during the travels, you know. And as you know, this is my second family, so I always like to spend time with all my mechanics and with all the people that is working in Aprilia.
We're talking about Aprilia. I mean, you couldn't have made yourself at home there any better than you have done, and also got as comfortable as you have done in the space of 12 months. What a journey you've been on.
Well, for sure, I've been on a difficult journey from the beginning, because it was pretty tough, especially to adapt to the bike and to get used to it. But as soon as I adapt, as soon as I get ready with the bike, I start to feel much better. And this is about technically speaking. But in the human side, I feel fantastic from day one in Aprilia. They were excellent to me. They were very open. And I always feel, as I said, like my second family, you know, especially because I spend a lot of time with them. And all the time we go together, I enjoy. So I feel very relaxed. I feel very positive. I feel happy. Of course, I miss my ladies, but, you know, now here, you know, I feel very good, and I also enjoy these times a lot.
There was a bit of a turning point for you in terms of results, making that progress with the RSGP this year, and obviously resulting in, more recently, some nice pieces of silverware to add to your collection. What was that turning point?
Actually, I improved a lot after the Mont Melo test. We found out a setting which was more suitable the way I ride the bike. So after that, I start to increase my level. And we arrived to Aragon. I have not a good experience last year, but this year I think it can be very different. So I just feel ready, I feel prepared. And I'm preparing myself, you know, for what is coming. And every time I feel more ready. You know, physically I feel more strong. I feel better on the bike, and that's very important.
Do you know what I think was really cool to hear? I think it might have been Romano Albiciano who said this, is that next year they are very much set on building you and Aleix two completely different bikes to suit your style, which, as we know, it's not that common amongst the manufacturers.
Yes, normally the manufacturers did one bike and you have to adapt. You know? But with Aprilia, I said many times, we are working very, very closely. And also we are working on a way which they want both riders to be on the top. So, for sure, I need something different than Aleix. I ride totally different, and my riding position is different. I'm much smaller and lighter, so it's a very, very different. We are very different riders. But it is very cool that Aprilia wants to do a bike, you know, or two bikes different for every rider, and that's great. That's great because I think I will reach my maximum potential in this factory, and it's going to be a nice show. I'm really, you know, enthusiastic and really motivated for it.
Great to hear you sound so positive. Do you have a quick look in the bedroom? If you don't mind.
Of course. We go.
Have a quick look. Okay. So we've obviously seen the living space. Then this is the. I'll let you go first.
When we go here, we first of all go to the bathroom.
Is there enough room? Shall I come in as well? I don't know why I'm ducking. Oh, yeah. Cool.
Okay, this is the bathroom. Nothing special.
I mean, like, it's
nothing special.
You have what you need.
Yeah, exactly.
Shower,
that's
sink,
quick shower,
you know,
and go.
Toilet.
And this is the bathroom.
Do you guys want to go in?
Yeah, of course. Go in.
I'm not coming in with my
Okay.
It's
and
so
then,
cozy.
It is very good. And but as I mentioned, you know, we have to modify a lot. You know, with the baby, this.
Oh my gosh!
It's not possible. The you know.
I mean,
the,
as a mom, I
sharp,
see all these dramas.
The sharp points we need to delete, so I need to modify.
Can I ask you a quick question?
Yeah,
something
of course.
I've always wondered. So, what time do you wake up?
Today, 7.
And is it purely because of everybody warming the bikes up in pit lane?
No.
You just
because
have to
there
get
is,
up
even if they warm up the bike, you can sleep.
Can you?
This track cancels the noise a lot.
Oh, okay.
So, if you close everything, it's very quiet.
I always wondered that.
And
what about when we have, like, campsites and things that are quite close, and
yeah,
they
like
go and they're like setting fireworks off and stuff.
I go to the hotel.
Oh, you do? Okay.
Also in Mugello, in the past I went to the hotel, so many times if it's impossible to sleep, like for example I try Friday, you know, like if there is a lot of noise, they are making a lot of party, which is
party.
Nice, eh?
It's
we
nice
like
back.
You know?
Yeah, exactly. But I can understand if
but
you're trying
I go
to
the hotel. I go to the hotel because if not I don't
fair
sleep.
Enough.
Yeah, it looks like you are in the party.
I mean, I remember, I've not been to Argentina for a few years, but when we used to go to Argentina, we used to stay just off the main square. And there was one year, I swear my bed was like vibrating for the noise of the parties, and they don't stop early. It's like 6 o'clock in the morning. You're like, oh my god.
That's the feeling I have when it's in Le Mans.
Yeah.
Which the stadium and the stage are close.
They put on a good show there.
The motorhome just is vibration. Bouncing. Yes, exactly.
Anyway, before I leave you, we'll come out here.
Okay.
And just before I leave you, I obviously need to get a quick word on how things were in FP1. Because I was hearing from a couple of riders that grip at the moment, not ideal. But I'm guessing more rubber laid down this afternoon won't be too bad.
Well, I think it was positive, the FP1, even if the position was not great. But it was positive to understand the setting we need to use. We have like two kind of settings, one setting when there is no grip and one setting when there is grip.
Yeah.
So we start with the setting of Misano that was very grippy. And of course, now we will modify the bike and we will be in the front, I'm sure. We will improve a lot this afternoon.
Yeah.
But it is true that the track is very slippery and it's a crazy feeling on the track, you know? Like it's never cut the grip, you know? You are all the time floating. So it is different. It is very different because we arrived from Misano, one of the best, to one of the worst in terms of grip. So it's pretty different.
That's why you guys are the best. You adapt to the conditions. Maverick, just before I leave you, we have something called MotoGP's pole predictor, where you have to guess what the time of this year's pole time will be.
Okay.
I'll give you a reference point and let you know what it was last year, unless you remember.
46.3.
Oh, there you go. I'm not even going to check.
Yeah, of course.
Okay, have a look.
I know very well.
Oh, it is actually that one.
This is FP1. No, this is not.
But normally it has pole time down at the bottom. Okay, now I have it.
Here, not here, yes. Magnaya, 6-3-2-2.
Okay, so what do you think it's going to be this year?
6-5.
Yeah?
Yeah. 6-5. I don't think it's going to be a lap record.
Okay.
Because it's not the same amount of grip of last year.
Mm-hmm.
And also the condition is going to be very hot. So I think 6-5, pole or front row. So that's the main target. That's what I want to do.
There we go. I was going to say, I'm not going to be that person that asks you here because you've got to pick yourself. Anyway, Maverick, I'm going to leave it here. I'm going to leave it here with you guys because nobody needs to see me try and walk down those steps. But thank you so much for welcoming us in.
No problem.
Have a great afternoon and obviously like amazing
weekend. I hope all the fans will enjoy the Aragon GP. Of course, at Aprilia, we will try to make an amazing show and we will try to win the race. We will go very hard for it. So I'm working very, very hard on myself to improve and to be at the maximum.
Thanks so much, Maverick.
And thank you guys.
Later on this afternoon for FP2.